Hi, I'm Rob, and today I'd like to show you a few table saw inserts, especially the zero clearance. And they have a lock, and that's what I'd like to show you. Well, here we see four inserts, four inlays. It has four locks, all of them have a lock, and the adjusters. You see, so I had to make quite a number, in this case 16. You see here a recess, and they all have a recess that is for the dust collection inside. There is a canvas curtain or whatever, and that falls exactly in here, so that you have to take out. And this is then 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 30 degrees, and or 60 degrees and 45 degrees, and the 45 gave me the most trouble. Well, this is then the 45 degree part for the 45, and that gave me the most trouble. First of all, well, 45, it's not really that difficult, but soon as you place this one like this in the machine, the saw blade, that gets then a different position, because the saw blade goes up like this. So you get a bit of a difference. But anyway, to take it out in the underside, I thought in the end it's better to do it with a router. So I routered a bit away, almost half the plate, 6 mil, quarter inch, what I milled away. And what gave also quite a hassle, and that was those little tips, those extrusions in the end, you know, in the casted model of the factory, they are very small, like this. But then I thought, well, it's open from here to here in the machine anyway, so why not make then one big lip? And that's what I did in here. You see, in the end, it takes a few before you get really the hang of it, and you think, well, this or that is better, you know. So that's what I did. So now I'm gonna do it in the future like this. It's way stronger, you know. Okay, now for the 45. The arbor, the shaft of the motor where the blade is situated on, comes very high towards the top surface of the tabletop. And as you can see in here, this is a recess. I had to make this for the arbor, and partly also for the nut what comes on the arbor. And that gave quite some trouble before I really knew what kept the plate from going down. Okay, after routering the circumference of the plate, we need still a little recess. Is a piece of canvas to close it off for the dust, and that runs in here, so we have to take a little gap out, and that you see in here. So that is 19 by 30 mil, so that you can do also on the router. First of all, mark the underside of your plate and check every time when you turn it around and so that you are busy on the right side of the plate. Otherwise you do it maybe a mirror image, and that's not what you want. Okay, now we're gonna fit it in. Well, that's neat, that's good. When you fit it in, doesn't want to go in totally, because the saw blade is in the way. So then you get
If you start the saw blade, you can make a small indentation, small cut in it, and then it falls into it. If it doesn't fall into it, and it stays more like this, and you did already a bit the saw cut, but it still stays like this, take a good look. There's this lip is not too thick. If that lip is a little bit too thick, it also will stay a bit inclined. Okay, here you see the lock mechanism. This is then the underside of the lock. It's quite simple, three washers, a nut, then the locking plate, and a washer and a cap nut, metric 5. Give the lock plate a twist, just give it a little turn, and that's it. Well, I hope it was an informative video, and maybe you can use it in the future for your own project. And anyway, thanks for watching, and maybe till the next time. Bye bye.